talk about mine.
There's purity in physical pursuits because it doesn't matter what your social status is. It doesn't matter how people perceive you. When it comes down to how long can you stay in that pool, when it comes down to how far can you run, right. When it comes down to how much can you push yourself past the part where you want to quit, right. How far can you keep going? There's a purity in that that dissolves social order, all that bullshit. What people think about you goes out the window. Who are you right now?
That's right.
Who are you right now?
That's a true statement, and I look at it as psychological warfare. That's where I started learning that life is one big psychological warfare that you play on yourself. You play on yourself, man. The most important conversation I ever had is with myself. I was telling myself it was so wrong, it was so misguided, and other people start to write that dialogue for you also, and it starts to be what you say to yourself every single day. And I started creating a whole nother warfare. A whole nother battle started becoming. I was like, oh, hang on a second, guys. You have these tools. You have these tools. Your life was basically the perfect grounds for training for where you need to go in your life. All the beatings, all the bullying, all the learning disabilities, all the struggles. It was the absolute perfect training ground to go to where you need to go. And that's how I started looking at my life versus woe is me, poopy pants, kick a rock down the street mentality. It was not. God just hooked you right up. He hooked you right up with the perfect place. You were training. You were training for this stuff. You have the advantage of everybody else versus, my God, they're so above me. They came from a great family. Mom and dad love them. They didn't have a learn. They didn't stutter. They didn't struggle. No, man, your struggle is what made you who you are now. So I started flipping this into a whole different, I started being a master of what I was scared of. I was scared of my mind. And I became literally a master of that mind. And that's what from now on, it sets me apart from most people.
That is a big part of the story is when you go over your childhood, your abusive father, and then having this great guy that was gonna become your stepdad, and then he gets murdered. It's like right when you're about to get out of it, everything right. Looks good, boom, and then he gets murdered. It's like these things really did sort of set you up to start from scratch again. You just go, okay, roger that. You start from scratch. And now you have that attitude. You developed it through all of these horrible personal experiences, all the trials and tribulations, all the evil shit that people try to do to you. That sort of set you up to be able to deal in a way that a lot of people can't.
I used to look at my life from a different vantage point. When you're in all the muck, you're just walking in muck and walking in muck and walking in muck. You don't see that if you look off to the left of the muck, there's a sidewalk. Get off of it. You have your head down looking in this muck. Once I saw the sidewalk, got the sidewalk, I got a little break and I got a different vantage point. From the sidewalk, I found a cliff. Then I found a mountain. I got way up high on top of my life and looked back down on it and said, okay, I got to figure this out. I'm not going anywhere. I'm starting to lie. So when you have a messed up foundation, I started lying about everything. I wanted people to like me. I wanted to be accepted in some society of life, some social society. I say, man, this isn't the right way. I'm messed up here, I'm messed up here, I'm messed up everywhere. And so I realized the worst thing that happened to me is I lost myself. I never had myself, I never found myself. I had no self-esteem. So I knew through working out and through learning, it took a lot for me to learn also. I started finding self-esteem. Once I found that, that's when doors start opening up. I stopped caring about people, what they thought, being judged. Wow, if I say this, if I started right now, are you gonna make fun of me? I stopped caring about that. That's when my life started really changing for me, slowly but surely.
That's such an important point when you're talking about the working out, because a lot of people, when they think about working out, they think of it as being a physical thing.
Right, no, no. I did it for mental. People always say, my God, like, no, I didn't care about losing weight. I didn't care about being the fastest person. I wasn't making the Olympics. I wasn't going to pros. I could barely read and write when I was a junior in high school. I wasn't going anywhere. I had a callous over the victim's mentality. I saw working out as a way for me to build calluses on my mind.